What represents your biggest opportunity?
I think being a local market and a small business, as many people here are, I think your stats on what iGens are looking for and millennials in terms of buying local and buying small is a big opportunity. I think that past generations have talked that language but not really lived it. And I think that that younger generation is willing to spend money for mm-hmm. quality products and for those elements, for buying local, for keeping it small. Whereas the other generations, I think, probably were willing to sacrifice their own desires for price. So I think that is a big opportunity for us. I think the challenge that goes with it, I know that wasn't part of your question, but I think the challenge then for us is where do we put our money, particularly in the grocery industry? Do we put it into kiosks that allow them to buy more grocerant type products? Do we put it into digital? Do we put it into online? We don't do online shopping for the reasons you described. Our store is more experiential. We need people to come in order to get those sales. And so online has just not been something we've done. But I think that's the challenge that goes along with that opportunity is choosing where you put your money.
Yeah, and what Mintel has found about young adults is you might skeptically say that, sure, they spend a lot more when they're young, but as soon as they get married, reality will hit. Well, you know what they've done is they are the ones that have led the innovation on baby food. Baby food was, as you know, sold in jars for decades exactly the same way, and now they're not only buying fresher, different kinds of baby foods, but making baby food. Which, of course, requires ingredients that generally cost more. So they're looking at, of course, you have to be more selective when you're a young family, but nevertheless, they are buying specific things and spending a relatively larger percent of their disposable cash compared to what older adults did when they were that age. Mm-hmm. So it has changed. Beth?
Yeah, and you know, for
biggest
us,
opportunity.
For us, you know, we're sitting in between the manufacturer and the retailer. So I think our opportunity is in knowing these trends, knowing the demand from the consumer for an experience, and knowing the demand for convenience and the grocerant. How do we build programs and make sure our assortment is really something that is going to benefit the retailers? How do we help the retailer achieve what they need to do in order to draw in this mm-hmm. new consumer?
So are you literally having to devise special programs for all of the new channel types that are out there? You mentioned grocerants, mm-hmm. one of
yeah.
those.
As we look at our strategy going forward, we have to look at, you know, so what do we need to do, to service that retailer who is looking for mm-hmm. an assortment for a grocerant or, yeah. you know, something that is, you know, the diet based or, you know, mm-hmm. what type of assortment, what type of program can we put together yep. to help them?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And do you do non-retail business as well, so healthcare, universities?
The majority of our business is retail.
Yeah, okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Good. Jay, biggest opportunity?
Again, I think our opportunities are endless. If we come up with new and innovative ideas for our customers, that's what they're looking for. They're looking for items that are not out there yet, that the younger generation is looking for. I mean, I think they're getting the opportunity to try new items. They travel a lot. They see new things. They want to try new things. So us as a distributor coming out with new items, innovative items, is important. And from the chef's perspective, you know, again, the staff is not always qualified to cook these items. So if we can bring it to market for them, it's that much better for it. Mm-hmm.